Professor Dave again, let's work some more with fractions.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We just learned how to add and subtract fractions, so let's go ahead and cover multiplication and division as well. First, let's see what happens when we multiply a fraction by a whole number. Take 1/3. If we multiply this by 2, then the whole number will multiply the numerator only. 2 times 1 is 2, so we get 2/3. If it was a 10, we would get 10/3. The denominator will not change, because it is telling us the magnitude of the fraction, not how many there are. If we have a slice of pizza, which is 1/8, when we multiply that by 2, meaning we have 2 slices of pizza, we have 2/8, not 2/4. 2/8 represents 2 slices, or 1/4 of the pizza. Now let's see what happens when we multiply 2 fractions. This is a little bit different from adding fractions, because when we add 2 fractions, they must have the same denominator, and then the denominator stays the same while we add the numerators. With multiplication, we can multiply any 2 fractions together. They don't have to have the same denominator, and we end up multiplying the terms in both the numerator and denominator. Take, for example, 2/3 times 1/2. On the top, we have 2 times 1, which gives us 2. On the bottom, we have 3 times 2, which is 6. That gives us 2/6, which will reduce to 1/3. That makes perfect sense, because we had 2/3, so after we cut that in half, we should have only 1/3 left. In this way, when multiplying 2 fractions, we can think of it in terms of multiplying by the numerator and then dividing by the denominator. This is why multiplying a fraction by a whole number only affects the numerator, because we can think of a whole number as a fraction where the denominator is 1. 1 times anything is 1, so the denominator will not change. Let's try another, 5/6 times 3/4. 5 times 3 is 15, and 6 times 4 is 24. So 15/24 is our answer. Now, in terms of division, it's a little trickier. Just like when multiplying a fraction by a whole number, when we divide a fraction by a whole number, we only divide the numerator. So 2/3 divided by 2 is 1/3. This is because dividing by a number is the same as multiplying by its reciprocal, which is just a fancy word for 1 over the original thing. That means that dividing by 2 is the same thing as multiplying by 1/2. This makes sense if you think about it, since dividing by 2 gives you half of what you started with. This will work the same way when we divide fractions by other fractions. 2/5 divided by 3/4 is the same as 2/5 times 4/3. We take the second fraction, flip it over, and then multiply to get our answer, which in this case will be 8/15. The only thing we have to be careful of is that we can't divide by 0. Dividing by 0 isn't the same as not dividing something up at all. That's what dividing by 1 does, because the same number remains. If we divide by 0, the result will be undefined, and this is a fact that will come in handy later in our study of mathematics. For now, we've learned how to multiply and divide fractions, so let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.